Hi, my name's John Mabry. I serve as pastor of Covenant EPC here in Monroe, Louisiana. And we are very thankful to be the recipients of the 2019 Bartlett Hess Award. Our story is the story of our God, who is able to do far more abundantly, exceedingly above all that we could ever ask or imagine. And that's what the Lord has done for us here at Covenant EPC over the last 8 years in His great work of revitalization here.
My name is Jonathan Wagner. I'm the associate pastor here at Covenant. When I was called to Covenant 5 years ago, John Mabry explained to me that although this church building looked like a well-established church founded in the early 1950s, the body of believers here was really still in its infancy, that this was essentially a new church. And given this reality, we have spent a lot of time asking, what is the church that God wants us to be?
We're the Skinners. This is Jermaine. We have Omri next in line up, Evans next, and then my wife Heather.
I'm Amy Gibbler.
And I'm Don Gibbler. We have been members of Covenant Presbyterian Church for about 7 years.
Hey guys, we're the Ravens.
Deborah.
Dave.
Daniel.
Sarah.
Lizzie.
William.
Caroline.
My name is Wallace Hargan, and this is my wife Ann. And we've been members here. We're not charter members, but we're almost made.
On your grace, keep my heart and guard my soul from the evils that I face.
Goes on here is a very, very traditional, very God-centered worship service. It is about God. It's not about us. And that really started to work on me as we came, you know, over the course of a few Sundays. They loved on us again, you know, our, what we call neighborhood flock. They were bringing us food and just really loving on us and taking care of us. And it was a really amazing thing to see the church be what the Bible says the church is supposed to be.
We think this church has become more and more transformed over the time that we've been here, and I was thinking, you know, where did that transformation come from? It's the preaching. I think what we hear from the pulpit is Jesus.
I think one of the evidences of transformation is the servant hearts of people in the church. Some of the most amazing servants that I've ever met who are willing to be personally inconvenienced and go out of their way to help other people, not only within the church, but also in the community. And I think that's really important.
Welcome to the Desert Street Shelter. This is a really soft spot in my heart. I've been doing it for 15 years, and the last 4 years I've been doing it with Covenant. And we do every third Friday of the month. And we were hungry for God's Word and could not find any place. But we found Covenant, and we have Pastor John and Pastor Jonathan preach and teach God's Word, and people are, I think that's what makes the whole difference is God's Word. Carnay here and her family are serving on our Guatemala summer mission trip, and Shirley and her husband have served for years.
Parents were charter members of Covenant Presbyterian Church. I was baptized here along with my three siblings. Dave and I were married at Covenant. Our children were baptized and married at Covenant, along with some of our grandchildren were baptized here. And until last year, when my mother died, there were four generations of our family sitting in one pew together.
I was first introduced to Covenant when Covenant was a new church, And then when I graduated and went off to other jobs, coaching jobs around the country, and we got back here in 1963, and we've been here ever since. People that we are that's joining our church are really, really, really nice people, and very talented people, and we certainly have enjoyed it.
Covenant is a place where the Word of God is preached and taught with boldness. The congregation actually insists on this, where the proclamation of the gospel and its implications are at the center of our life together.
We don't make God relevant. God makes us relevant. And I was like, this is the place where we're going to stay and actually learn from Scripture.
I think one of the things that has been important personally to Amy and to me is the sense of community within the church. We started meeting as home groups about probably 4 or 5 years ago, and that was a very important part of our experience, beginning to feel truly at home in the church, part of the church family, to develop some deeper relationships, to be able to support and encourage and pray for one another.
We've seen a lot of changes, we've seen a lot of growth, we've seen a lot of praying and staying by our family to watch the restoration and the renewal of our church.
It's been a sight to see the Lord work in us and through us, just from generation to generation. That was when we went to the membership and we did a capital campaign for the revitalization of our church. The Lord has just blessed us in so many ways.
One thing that usually draws visitors into Covenant is family. And as you can see, that is one of the most important things for our family in particular. It's to worship together. And we have since accumulated more of our extended family members that are here at Covenant, and friends that we go to church with, we now consider family. There was a time where the only child that walked down for children's church was William, and now there are just 20 to 30 children that rush down to see Pastor John and Pastor Jonathan each Sunday, and so it's just really, really special to see.
Holy Spirit's had a hold of this church now for several years, and it's going great, and we wish we weren't so old.
When Covenant came into the EPC, it was the Lord's doing and it was the Lord's timing. This congregation became a kind of oasis, if you will, for folks who had been seeking a church home, and they shared our vision of a reformed, evangelical, historically confessional congregation. And they joined with us, and the Lord has been adding to our number. And we give Him the praise and the glory for that. So thanks be to God for His greatness, His goodness, and His mercy to us. To God be the glory.